Hey guys, Taki here. In my last video, I talked about creating an AMOLED handheld for under $100. By the end of that video, I had created a prototype of something that can create a pseudo handheld with the only requirement that you need to be tethered unless you want to spend more money. The main thing that I did not attempt to do was add a wireless HDMI solution to my device, and that's partially because someone had already done that. In this video, we're going to take a first look at this interesting wireless hybrid solution. So let's just quickly start by going over some of the physical features of this. Right now I have this connected to a pair of Nintendo Switch Joy-Cons, and as you can see, it works flawlessly. These are both connected via Bluetooth to a PC that's off camera right now, and they are not connected to the actual main unit as they would be on a Switch. This device comes with a set of third-party controllers, but I've had some issues pairing these, so I'm opting instead to use official ones that are better supported. Now, one of the cool things about this product is that we can easily utilize Nintendo Switch Joy-Cons and all of the third-party options that exist. All you need to do is just slide the controller into place and it will lock in just as it does on a real Switch. There are a lot of third-party controllers for the Switch, and this thing having these rails is going to allow you to be able to find the perfect controller that fits your needs. It is an interesting idea that I'm surprised we haven't seen before this point. One thing that I have to point out is that these rails cannot charge your Joy-Cons that you're connecting to the unit, so you'd still need to find another way to charge them if you wanted to use them. But this bracket here is going to be our secret sauce, and it is robust from my testing thus far. Now let's take a look at the top, and we are going to do a direct comparison against the OLED Switch. This thing is a bit longer and larger than the main Switch unit, and that's mainly because our screen is much bigger. The thickness is also similar, but the casing material is slightly different between both units. There are still a few things that carry over from the official device. Starting from the side, you'll see that we have an HDMI input slot, and that is exactly what I had on my unit that I created. You can go tethered with this thing if you want, or you can go wireless like it is now. There are pros and cons to each that we will talk about in just a moment, but you do have a few other options here. You have a Type-C port that has the ability to accept DisplayPort signals, and they also have a separate slot for charging. In the middle here, you'll see that we have a copper air vent, and that is because this thing has active cooling in the module. It might seem strange for this to need a fan, but that's because wireless HDMI solutions actually generate a decent amount of heat when they are active. So this thing is going to need to be on whenever we have the wireless signal active, and you can feel that heat radiating across the shell during longer gaming sessions. You'll also consume a noticeable amount of battery doing so. To the side of that, you have an LED indicator light here to indicate the charging status and your wireless pairing status. We also have a headphone jack, with the remaining area dedicated to input buttons. These are used to control the OSD functions on this module, and the menu itself is pretty robust. You can customize a lot of this screen to make it look the way you want it. These are going to be things like screen saturation, color balance, brightness, and backlight intensity. We will cover that in a later video. On the back of the unit, you'll see that we have an air intake vent here, and that's going to feed our small fan inside. The noise from this is comparable to what you'd get on a real Switch, and it isn't anything to be too concerned about. To the side of this, you'll see a little window, and I'm not really sure what this is for, but we can see some PCB under the glass. On the bottom of the module, you'll see that we have two speaker holes, but this device only comes with a single speaker. It is a loudspeaker, so it's got that going for it, but I wish that we would have had two so we weren't stuck with mono sound. There is also a standard thread in the center if you wanted to put this on something like a tripod, but I don't expect that to be too common. Now, the mode that I'm in right now is wireless HDMI, and as long as you're in line of sight of your HDMI source, you are going to have a pretty good time with lag-free gaming. We could do some latency tests in a follow-up video, but I haven't been able to notice anything out of the ordinary switching between wireless and wired. Based on my last video, some people would say that this isn't a handheld because it relies on something else to feed it a signal, but I think that it is. It is a bit better than the thing that I created, and it's also better than the de facto option of just streaming to an Android phone because of how big this screen is. You could find Android tablets with screens of this size, but you'd be limited in the kinds of controllers that you could physically attach to the tablet. But I do want to show you the process of pairing this using the two HDMI solutions that we have so you can get an idea of how it is to use. So I currently have this connected to an HX90G, and you can see the wireless dongle is connected over here. Now, there are two things that you need to do when you're going to use this. This thing needs to be plugged into an HDMI slot, and you also need to power it with a Type-C cable. I mentioned that these things generate a bit of heat, and if you went to touch this right now, you'd feel that it is quite hot. Because of that, I probably wouldn't put this near other wires or in a place with bad ventilation. But this is what the process looks like when we pair the device. So we're gonna unplug this and you'll see that the screen will cut out. And I just wanna give you an idea of how long it takes to find and pair the HDMI signal. Once you connect this dongle, you'll see the LED indicator light on the dongle will change to green and the main module will flash red to show that it is pairing. The whole process is actually pretty fast, all things considered. It pairs very quickly, so you can use it in this way if you want. And the benefit of something like this is that you can basically adapt this module to anything that you want. I want to give you a glimpse into some of the versatility that you have with this system with something a bit different. So right now, we don't have this plugged in at all, and I have my Pi 800 already plugged in and turned on. So if we take this dongle and plug it into the HDMI port, you will see that it'll pair very quickly to project our SBC. And that's basically how easy it is to use the wireless HDMI mode. I also want to show you that the wired HDMI works, and it's just as fast as the wireless solution. And here's how the whole thing looks when you have the system connected to a powerful PC running Steam Big Picture. You basically get a Steam Deck with a higher resolution screen. Again, we are using wired HDMI now, and usually when I'm using this device, I will have at least one of these plugged in. Obviously, it's tethered right now, and a bunch of people would tell you that this is no longer a handheld because it's tethered, or that it was never a handheld to begin with because there's no processor in here, but I still think that this qualifies as a handheld. People are getting too caught up in the semantics of things that don't matter. I do want to explain why I opt to tether this in some cases. So if I'm using the wireless HDMI mode, the battery won't last for as many hours as I probably want to play because of how much power the wireless HDMI consumes. So if I really want to play something like Elden Ring for an extended period of time, the battery would give out far sooner than I would want to stop playing. In any case, I am probably close enough to a power outlet that I would just run this with a Type-C cable connected to it to charge while I'm playing. I do this kind of thing on many of the PC handhelds that I use and it never bothers me. Now let's say that I don't want to use wireless HDMI. In that case, I'm probably running a long HDMI cable to the device and my battery will last a bit longer. I could run one or both in that case without issue. If I'm playing close enough to a power source or my HDMI source, I will probably tether it to one or the other. I actually like using the physical HDMI connection more because the entire device generates far less heat when the wireless signal is not active and it feels more comfortable over an extended period of time. I think it's a nice trade-off if you aren't harping over being tethered that much. But yeah, that's going to be it for this first look video. I think this is a pretty interesting thing, given that it is the only retail product of this kind on the market. This thing is going to go on pre-sale in the future, and I'll have an in-depth video covering more, including panel and battery life statistics. I just wanted to get this first look video out so people can have an idea of what this concept looks like when it's done professionally and not by DIY. Happy gaming, everyone. Taki out.